I'm joined right now by Texas Lieutenant Governor Dan Patrick. He joins me on the phone. Governor, thanks very much for joining us this morning. Can you characterize the impact here to the broader economy? Put this in context for us, please.
Well, thank you, Maria. First of all, this storm is already record-setting with maybe 20 or 24 more inches of rain to come. So the economic loss and impact is going to be even greater. You have a city of 2.5 million in Houston, in Harris County, which is the third largest county in the country, of another 2 million plus. So you have about 5 million people impacted that I would say right now, generalizing across that entire area, most people are paralyzed in their neighborhood. You can get out some areas for some streets at some point, but eventually you're going to be blocked by water somewhere. We're going to break in the rain today, maybe a little while for a few hours, not much, and then be pounded again overnight. The economic impact, Maria, will be in the billions. Now, we have in Texas the Economic Stabilization Fund called the Rainy Day Fund, and we have $10 billion in reserve. And that $10 billion is more than most states have combined. So it's a healthy balance, but our budget is over $100 billion a year. It's about 10% of our budget. So we do have that as a backup for times in economic downturns or crisis like this. But our cost to individuals, many people do not have flood insurance. There are many people, Maria, who are flooding, who have never flooded before, who are now on their second floor or rooftops because the first floor is flooded. There will be hundreds and hundreds of thousands of homes impacted. I mentioned this to Harris Faulkner last night. Put this in perspective for your viewers around the country. The distance from Rockport, where the hurricane hit Thursday and devastated that small area, is about 200 miles from Houston. That would be like a storm hitting New York and Boston being flooded. And that's the distances we're talking to. All of those homes in between, and now, you know, Houston alone is larger than about 25 or 26 states in population. So now you have hundreds of thousands of people in Houston. San Antonio, many areas are underwater, and that's another 200 miles away. So you have this massive area. It's too early to calculate, but it will be in the billions and billions. I've seen one report from CoreLogic that said $39 billion potential if everyone was hit. I've seen Forbes come out with a report of $20 billion. Of course, our state we'll analyze all this after the fact, but it will be in the billions, one of the most, if not the most expensive storm ever.
Not only that, but talk to us about the businesses in the area. I mean, we know the impact to the oil and gas refineries and the facilities. Many are shut down. That's going to have a broad impact across the country, correct?
Yes, and of course, you know, my focus is Lieutenant Governor and Greg Abbott and President Trump and the White House has offered quick help and fast help to us. Which we greatly appreciate. But my focus is on life, but on the business side, I know this is a business-oriented show. We produce about 6 million barrels of oil a day, refined product. We have about 2 million now offline, so that's about a third. That's a rough number. Our refineries, to my knowledge, have not been damaged. Again, to my knowledge, have not been damaged. The problem will be, Maria, of people being able to go to work. You can't get out of your homes, and of course, all of the people who work in those refineries are focused on their families and their homes. And so I would anticipate that we will have our refineries offline longer than people thought. You know, at some point, you know, maybe they can be up and running Wednesday or Thursday. That's just a speculation. I really don't know because we don't know the impact of the rain. But that will have an economic impact as well. Plus, we've already deployed, the governor has deployed 1,800 guardsmen. I'm sure there'll probably be more in search and rescue. We have 900 state troopers now being pulled from all over the state in this area. Local cost for first responders is going to be significant. Just the cost of rebuilding and remodeling. And there's always a back end to that on the construction side and the repair side. But there's going to be a tremendous economic impact to our business. You can't open your business today. No one can get to your place. If you're selling pizza, you know, or you're selling movie tickets, no one can get out. So you're shut down. You know, I was supposed to be with you in an up-camera uplink today, as you know, and we couldn't get to the TV studios. In fact, one TV studio here has water in their first floor. This is going to have a tremendous economic impact. But, Maria, even though this is a Texas-sized storm, we will have a Texas-sized effort, and we are best prepared to handle this than any other place in the country, but it's going to be a long, long road, and some people won't be able to open their businesses for days or weeks, and some people won't get back to their homes potentially for months.
Which is why the administration, the federal government, was so fast in terms of responding to what Texas needs. Look, I know that it's hard to predict what's going to happen in the next couple of days in terms of the cleanup and the flooding, because we don't know the impact of more rain coming. So we'll keep checking back with you. Governor, thank you for your leadership. Thanks for joining us this morning.
Thank you. We appreciate the White House working with us quickly, and right now we're in rescuing lives first, and then after that it's rescue and recovery, and then after that, that next stage comes to clean up and build back. But right now we're focused on lives, and our first responders are brave and doing an incredible job all across this vast region. Thank you, Maria.
All right, thank you. We'll be watching and check back, of course. Thank you so very much, Lieutenant Governor Dan Patrick there.